I have to go. So, where's my gift?
Sergei, listen to me and don't react.
Someone filed a report about us.
What?
They didn't mention your name, but... but the KGB knows something. You better go, Sergei.
First off, Tom, you met Sergei and you're honoring his story, but what was the key just as far as balancing the script? You know, you're honoring his story, but you're also adding your own narrative to the entire story. What was the key for you as a co-writer in balancing the story within truth and as far as narrative fiction as well?
Yeah, it was a really amazing exercise in keeping to the truth of what Sergei went through, but also making the film as accessible as possible. That was one of the biggest challenges, actually, because the story, when you read it in its original form, is so idyllic in some ways that when you read it, it was almost like, how is this possible? It seemed so, like, because of the nature of the love in the story, it seemed so like there was no obstacle. And so actually we had to create or put in or just sort of draw out more of the obstacles to kind of give this drama and this substance, because Sergei's original book doesn't really go into the danger so much of the world. And so we had to kind of bring that into a way in which all kinds of audiences would understand it. So that really was probably one of the biggest changes that we made, that and actually the character of Louisa, because in the original book, Louisa is portrayed as quite a formidable character and not a very likable character. And we really wanted to give her a very genuine and as equal a voice, because, you know, her tragedy is massively impactful in the story too.
I really loved how ambitious this production was. Can you just talk in a layman's perspective, all the visual setups you guys had to do? How are you guys able to actually get it done? Because I'm thinking of all of the setups you had to do on a daily basis throughout the production. Very cool.
Yeah, I think probably one of the days I had about 7 costume changes, and we did like maybe like 4 or 5 different locations. It was pretty tight in terms of moving around, but we had an amazingly experienced team and experience in life experience and also film experience. You know, so many of our team had lived through the Soviet Union, and so they really knew all the details and were able to like pick out things if they weren't quite accurate. But yeah, the level of ambition really comes from both Peter and my sort of ethos, which was like, have no compromises. And so that did mean that, you know, at times, you know, things would have to be moved, or we'd have to kind of go back to another location another time if it wasn't looking quite right yet. And certainly has been very ambitious in terms of, for actually quite a small budget for what the film looks like. It's quite a compliment actually that a lot of people have said, you know, it looks a bit like the budget would be like if you add a zero to actually what we did it with, because it's 4.2 million euros. And yeah, getting actual flying sequences like Russian or like Soviet planes and making it actually look like real was pretty hard on our VFX company, for example. They were like, ooh, but I think they did a terrific job.
Speaking of terrific job and real life performances, can you just talk about your co-stars, Oleg and Diana? They really feel, you actually feel that even though it's an elaborate production with whatever budget you had, it's very, in general, a very intimate story. And these performances feel very lived in. How did you guys get there? And what was it like just collaborating with both of them?
We were very fortunate enough to schedule several weeks of rehearsals. And that's, you know, not that often done to such a degree, I think, on film productions anyway. And so that really allowed us to really get to know each other, like as people, but also as the performers and how they were going to interact. And also at that point, Peter and I were open-minded enough to go, if there were any significant contributions which they wanted to give, or how we could steer the character a little bit more into the truth, a little bit more into the believability, and more into the chemistry, then we were open to do that. But yeah, Diana coming from Russia and Oleg being from Ukraine, there was kind of quite a difference in the cultural background. And it was like through those weeks that we really had to get to know quite how it was going to be. But they were both amazingly generous actors, actually. You know, Diana has this quality of being able to be very like vulnerable and tender, and then at the same time, you know, kind of asserting as well, and being having a strong presence. And then, you know, Oleg not really speaking much English before actually shooting the production. And that was a real challenge for both of us, because he didn't speak much English, I didn't speak much Russian. And so our chemistry really came through spending time in physical presence with each other more than being able to share at all, really much on an intellectual level.
You know, just meeting Sergei, I've read in past interviews, you and Peter describe him as pretty much romantic and open-hearted. And for you, did you find a bond with him during your encounter? Because it seems to me, just, I'm a hermit, I don't like to travel too much, you're a world traveler, I think one would need an open heart or a sense of romance or maybe most importantly, a love of life as far as to actually travel like you do. Did you share that kind of bond with Sergei? Did you see that in him as far as in you two as well?
I definitely saw an immense life force. Like, I think to dare to go after a level of truth in following your heart, following love, as he did at a time where he was risking his life, they both were. That takes a lot of courage. And I'd say that that's probably one thing that has really inspired me, actually, through the creating of this film, is getting to know him, is to being truer and truer and truer to myself. And I think that actually the truer you are to yourself, actually the more energy you end up having, because you're not having to, you know, dare I say, waste too much energy on creating an illusion of yourself to the world. And so I'm a great believer in you know, basically making that gap as small as possible, so that who you are and how you show up in the world is not in a dissonance with how you appear and who you really are. And so that was, again, something that I really like took from him, was to radically be true to himself, and, you know, also not to be silly about it. He wasn't, you know, he certainly wasn't sort of showing off around it. He was just very much is wearing his heart on his sleeve and taking things in the moment, you know, openly flirting with a male waiter in a restaurant in a suburb of Moscow, like, you know, raised Peter and my eyebrows certainly quite enough, but it was not in a way which was, you know, dislikable or kind of made you feel uneasy. It was actually just this lightness that he had, and this courage. So yeah, that really informed how to play him, but also has really deeply impacted me.
Final question, Tom, just regarding being true to yourself and just being a traveler, you know, for a time you're living in Estonia, you went to Namibia and Antarctica, and you're a writer, producer, and lead for Firebird. You talk about courage. Where does that come from? Does that come from your childhood, or did you mature into who you are? Because you've done so many things in your life, it would seem, from the outside looking in.
Thank you. That's a really good question. I think it has to do with probably being like quite insular, actually, when I was younger, and kind of wanting to see. I was always very hungry to experience more, and you know, my mum would be like, you know, Tom, like, you always want the best of everything. Like, I was like, you know, opening the new jar of peanut butter even though the old one is not finished, like things like that. And so I think that, yeah, I'm always asking the question, is there more of life? And I think if you ask, then sometimes a lot of the time it shows up as more. So I guess it comes from daring to ask. And it can be a very stressful and tumultuous journey as well doing that. But honestly, I wouldn't change any of it.
Really enjoyed your film. Thank you, Tom, so much for your time.
Thanks a lot.